Evening, everybody. A great night at the Grand Ole Opry. We've got two Hall of Famers on the show tonight, the King of Country Music and Minnie Pearl. And we've got Connie Smith to sing for you. And the Vice President of the United States will be here, Mr. George Bush. Stay with us. Let's go on stage now for the King of Country Music, here's Roy Acuff and his Smoky Mountain Boys.
From the great Atlantic Ocean to the wide Pacific, from the green and growing mountains to the South Carolina, she's mighty tall and handsome, she knows quite well my own. She's a combination of the Wabash Cannonball. She came down to Birmingham one cold December day. As she rode into the station, you could hear all the people say, there's a girl from Tennessee, she's long and she's tall. She came down to Birmingham on the Wabash Cannonball. That is Oswald over to my left for this show roll. Chuck Jackson made it for him long years ago. Jerry Whitehurst is at the piano for this evening. Jerry, it's the Cannonball. Right in. Our eastern states are dandy, so the people always say, and Chicago by the way, from the hills of Minnesota where the rippling waters fall, no changes can be taken on the Wabash Cannonball. Charlie Collins with that beautiful 45 Martin, he's been rehearsing all day here in Offerland. Here
yourself, Johnny.
Harry McNeely with the harmonica. Here's to Daddy Claxton, may his name forever stand and always be remembered round the courts of Alabama. His earthly race is over and the curtain round him falls. We'll carry him home to victory on the Wabash Cannonball. Howard Forster with his Stradivarius. She glides along the woodlands, through the hills and by the shore. Hear the mighty rush of the engine, hear that lonesome hobo squall. Hear traveling through the jungles on the Wabash Cannonball. All aboard for Opryland, USA. Thank you for being with us. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, you're very nice. We're so happy to have you, and we hope you'll enjoy our Grand Ole Opry. We're on the Nashville Network this evening, and we want you to stay with us, and I'm sure that you'll enjoy. We have a lot of fine people here that I'm sure you'll be glad to meet. And don't forget, in the morning at 10 o'clock, Opryland gates will swing open for you, and we'll have fun all day tomorrow in Opryland. Let's go to for just a minute and listen to what some of the announcers has to say. There's Barbara Bush, the wife of the Vice President of the United States. Barbara, we are delighted to have you with us tonight at the Grand Ole Opry. Thank you. Beside Mrs. Bush is a gentleman who has performed at the Opera House many times. He's an outstanding pianist in his spare time, but he serves us here in the state of Tennessee as our governor, and I'd like you to please welcome Governor Lamar Alexander to our audience, please. Thank you. And beside them are Mr. and Mrs. Bud Wendell. Bud is my boss, and he's the president of Opryland USA. That little lady sitting by me is Janice, his beautiful wife. Janice, we're glad to have you, dear. Thank you. The next gentleman comes to us from the state of Texas by the way of Washington, D.C. He's been visiting here in Tennessee and accepted our invitation to join us at the Opry tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, please make welcome Barbara Bush's escort, the Vice President of the United States, Mr. George Bush.
Well?
Mr. President, Vice President, we're so glad to have you visiting with us, and you're not a stranger to our Grand Ole Opry audience. You have been on stage with me here before and all the boys back here, and mm-hmm. We knew when you was coming to Nashville, if you would come out here and see us, that you'd get a real warm welcome. These people love you, and I'm just delighted to have you on stage. This is not the only place that you and I have ever met on stage. I have been with you on stage a time or two in other places, and I know that you're just as well received all over the country as you are here at the Grand Ole Opry. So we're so happy to have you.
Listen, Roy, we want this show to go on, but I just want to say as a country western fan, you know, Barbara and I hit that end button on our little radio, and we go to sleep listening to you all and wake up in the morning same way. So I'm just thrilled, I know, with everybody else from across the country to be here, and thanks for letting me come back.
I think you're truly a country musician, music lover.
Well, I'm a listener. I'm not a singer like you. Blue eyes crying in the rain and cannonball and all this kind of stuff.
Yeah, well, I enjoy my work here at the Opry, and it's good, clean entertainment, our country music is, and we're pleased with it. We want you not only happy to have you tonight, but we want you to come back in our part of the country and visit with us again.
Thank you, sir.
I've got now, wait a minute, don't run away. Just don't get nervous, huh?
I'm nervous. I got too much talent around here.
I'm a little country boy. let me have this microphone. I don't like to leave a microphone vacant. You know, you saw back in my dressing room the picture of you and I when we were at the, what was that play, up at Dayton, Ohio?
Bogey Busters.
Bogey Busters. And I remember the remark you made that night. They were presenting me with a jacket, and you said, if you're not well acquainted with Roy Acuff, you don't put a jacket on him. And you put the jacket on me. You said, I think I'm the one to do it. I'm going to have to strip you down.
All right.
I sure hope this thing fits. Hey, let me show you what's on it.
All right.
Look at
that. All right.
Grand Ole Opry.
That's beautiful.
TM.
Pretty great. All right. Good. All right. Thank you, Roy. It's perfect. It's perfect.
You can play golf in that one.
All right. Thank you, sir. Good luck.
Thank you, Mr. Vice President.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. You're real gentlemen. Now we'll switch away from the announcer for just a second. She's with her, and I've never introduced her to an audience that the audience didn't seem to thoroughly enjoy her, with a lot of laughing fun out of her, and I've never seen her walk in front of an audience that she didn't thoroughly enjoy going on, because she's just a natural for an entertainer. She came to the Opry several years ago, and our boss man at that time was Mr. George D. Hay, the solemn old judge, and she went to the solemn old judge and told him she wanted to do a little talking on our radio. She'd been listening to him back down in Grinder's Switch. And he put her on, and she's been talking ever since. I thank everyone in Georgia. She's a member of our Country Music Hall of Fame, very deserving. We're real proud of her. She stays very busy at her work, entertaining and helping people that have needed help. She does a lot of charity work and all around over the country, and we're real proud. So she's with us tonight, and I know that you're going to enjoy her. Would you make her welcome, please, from Grinder Switch, Tennessee?
I'm just proud to be here. just a big night, ain't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Got these awful important people here, and we're so proud to have you all here, and everybody's having such a good time. I told everybody at Grinders.
We've even got your next-door neighbor with us.
That's right. Handsome feller, too.
Yes. Governor Mar Alexander.
That's right. He's a very nice neighbor, too.
I bet he is.
He comes over every once in a while and borrows a cup of sugar. He's a cute man. But you know, Vice President Bush is very handsome, too.
Real fine man.
Yes, he is. When I left home this morning, Lizzie Tinkham, you know, she's the old maid I'm always telling you about. The one that don't want nothing but women pallbearers.
Oh.
I said, why is that? And she said, well, if them old men won't take me out while I'm alive, I don't want them taking me out after I'm dead. She's a sight, I'm telling you. But she told me before I left home this morning, she said, if you see any handsome fellas up there at the Opry tonight, flirt with them just for me. So I got in here tonight, and I seen a handsome feller, and I flirted with him just for Lizzie, not for me. And then I seen another handsome feller, and I flirted with him just for Lizzie, not for me. But when I seen that handsome Vice President Bush, that's when I decided to go into business for myself.
Pay no attention to her, Barbara.
No, I can't compete with Mrs. Bush. She's too beautiful. Well, I wanted to bring my brother. I told you what happened the first time I tried to take him to town.
What?
All the fellas run from him. One fella pointed his finger at my brother and said, what's the matter with that old boy? He's got spots all over his face. Has he got the smallpox? And I said, no, brother ain't got the smallpox. We just been trying to learn him to eat with a fork. That is the first time we rid a train. We was coming in here to Nashville to buy him a store-bought suit. We'd caught him and put shoes on him. Had to plait his toes. He's got awful big feet.
You got him house broke?
Oh, Roy, you're so bad. Well, but we brought him into town, and we had a wonderful time. Brother is the kind of a feller, if you see him pushing a wheelbarrow, he'll have it upside down. You say, turn it over. He say, uh-uh, they'll put something in it.
Smart boy.
He's smart.
Yes,
he really is. He's smart boy. He ain't a failure. He just started at the bottom, and he likes it there. Him and Uncle Nabob. Uncle Nabob's got a bad habit of dipping into the corn squeezing. Says it takes a little nip every once in a while, kind of steady his nerves. He gets pretty steady. Sometimes he don't move at all. The other night, Aunt Ambrosie noticed he's going to be out late. She got one of them Halloween false faces. She didn't need it. All of our family favors. She put that on, put a sheet all up over, and hid out there by the bushes where she knowed Uncle Nabob's coming by. Sure enough, long about midnight, he'd come a-weaving in there and come up by that bush, and she jumped out and said, boo, I'm the devil. Uncle Nabob said, well, shake hands with your kinfolks, a marriage, a sister.
I haven't heard that in a while.
I told you they celebrated their 50th anniversary.
What's that?
They've celebrated their 50th anniversary last week. Yes. Woke up that morning and she said, just think, 50 years ago today we got married. Go out in the backyard and kill the biggest rooster we've got. And Uncle Nabob said, why would you blame a chicken for something that happened 50? Oh, I love him. He is wonderful. But my brother, I heard a noise down at the barn the other night, and I looked, and he had got him a new mule. And the mule's ears was too long. He couldn't get the mule in the barn because the mule's ears was too long. And brother was sawing off the top of the barn door to get the mule in. I said, well, it's a dirt floor. Why don't you just dig a trench and take the mule in that way? Brother said, it ain't his legs that's too long, it's his ears. Now I'm going. I had to quit up there at home. Looked like it made the dog's house bad. I'd like to sing one called Jealous Hearted Me, please. Oh, that's terrible. I've had trouble with my throat. I went to the doctor, and he said he didn't like the looks of it either. He said I looked like I'd washed my neck and forgot to iron it. But I'm going to sing anyway. He gave me some medicine. It liked to kill me. It wasn't the medicine hurt me. It was the directions on the bottle said, take it 2 nights of running and skip a night. Have my cover, you can have my tea, but just you let my fella air be. I'm jealous. Jealous hearted me. I'm just as jealous as I can be. Now I like fiddle sour crying. Will I get my mail on the rural route? I'm jealous. Jealous hearted me. I'm just as jealous as I can be. Now I've got a man and a bulldog too. My man don't bite, but my bulldog do. I'm jealous. Jealous hearted me. I'm just as jealous. Ooh.
You were talking about your brother. Is he still in business with this young fellow by the name of
Handsome Peabody?
Handsome Peabody.
Yeah, they're hauling hay. They've been hauling hay from up in Bowling Green, Kentucky.
Uh-huh, that's where Charlie Bush lives.
Is that where he lives?
That's where he lives.
They've been hauling hay from Kentucky. Uh-huh. They've been paying $5 a bale up in Kentucky.
Yeah.
And they've been selling it for $5 a bale in Grinder Switch.
Are you kidding?
Yeah. Handsome said, we ain't making no money. Brother said, maybe we need a bigger truck.
Thank you. I want to bring in another very fine little lady that's a member of our Grand Ole Opry and has been for a few years, and we're real proud of her. She's not only a beautiful girl, she sings a beautiful song, and I'm satisfied that you will enjoy every minute she's out here and every song that she sings. This is her band moving in back here right now, and you gentlemen can kind of make around, and I'll tell them that this... Everybody whispering but me. And I'm talking out. I want you to make her welcome, and I know you're going to enjoy her. Please, Miss Connie Smith. Come on here.
Thank you. Could I just have one moment with you? We're here all alone, just us two. Let me try to tell you in a few you.
we'll break away here for just a minute for the announcement. Thank you, Connie. We'll be back in a minute.
On stage now.
All the way.
And also Miss Connie Smith. Connie, they kindly got after me for changing the program there, but I'm used to running the program like I want to, not like they want to.
You know who I'm following.
I appreciate you staying with me. We're going to do one that I think all of you will enjoy. Maybe all of you can enjoy singing with. I Saw the Light.
I wandered so aimless, I filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like an angel in the night.
Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside.
The blind man, I wandered alone. Weary and tears I claimed for my own. Then like the blind man that God gave back his sight.
Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow in sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
Wander and stray, for straight is the gate and narrow's the way. Now I have traded the wrong for the right.
Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside.
It's so nice of you to be in our audience here, and we hope that you have enjoyed our program. It's so nice that Vice President George Bush came to be with us, with his lovely wife, Barbara, and Governor Lamar Alexander, and our boss man, Mr. Bud Wendell. We're so glad that they could be in our audience with us this evening, and we hope that you folks will tune in again next Saturday night on TNN. Thank you for being with us this evening. Good night to you all.
The King of Country Music, Roy Acuff.